got to win the game to the people who run it, to the people who own it, that unless you're free, the machine will be prevented from working at all, from working at all, from working at all.
Don't lay down and die because a new world order, the business of the day for the elite, when they're coming to take your freedoms.
Hello again, human beings from the planet Earth. We're at change.org. I want to make you aware of a brand new petition that just came out. You can see 11 supporters. You see I've signed it. I'll read it to you. I want to give a big shout out and thanks to John Anthony Fairhurst. He is the admin for the Facebook event and organizing the Million Mask March that's coming up. And this is a pivotal moment as far as I'm concerned, because it's bringing together so many issues. It's bringing people together. And we got to do this, folks, because you've heard it, over and over. When peaceful means run out, violence is the next option. And myself and many, many others don't want to see that. But we also see that something has to be done about the chemtrails, the economy, the this, the that, the every damn thing we see. And we see a lot. And all those issues need to be discussed, and they need to be discussed by the people. And the government needs to be aware that the people have come together on these issues, and that our patience is running thin. So anyway, let me read this to you. I'll link you below. Link you to the event page on Facebook, and you can connect with John and the Twitter account as well. President of the United States of America, recognize and codify the outline Ninth Amendment rights. Scroll down here. The rights of the people of the United States are not granted by the government. They are indeed self-evident. The Ninth Amendment to the United States Constitution outlines that nothing in the Constitution shall be used to disparage any rights held by the people. We, the people of the United States, take this opportunity to notify the government of rights that we hold, as many of the actions over the last few decades have violated them, and the situation has become intolerable. The information is petition enacted through policy can remedy these intolerable acts. In support of this petition, we will be gathering for the Million Mask March at the National Mall on November 5th, 2013, as simultaneous meetings occur in major cities throughout the United States and the world. We are hoping for a response from the government by this date. The following are the rights we are informing the government that we retain. The right to be free of government surveillance except upon a specific court order based on probable cause. The right to know that any law enacted by the government will apply equally to lawmakers, the enforcement class, and the people at large. The right to provide our children with an education through home-based curriculum, a religious-based school, or a private school in lieu of a government-funded school. The right to live free from secret courts and to be informed of charges against us in a timely manner. The right to be secure in all of our electronic communications, and any violation must be authorized specifically in writing by a warrant specifying the probable cause for such violation. The right to refuse medical treatment. The right to know about any unnatural modification or ingredients in our food. The right to peacefully assemble on any public lands. The right to document through video, photo, or audio any public servant while they are acting in their official position. The right to a restoration of all civil rights and forgiveness of any debts to the government incurred by a conviction in a court of law over a period of 7 years from the date of conviction. The right to be free from government interference in any religious ceremony. The right to keep and bear arms in the form of rifle, pistol, or shotgun without regulation, limitation, or registration. We grant the government the privilege of regulating any fully automatic assault weapons, silencer, or short-barreled shotguns, as well as the ability to prohibit any violent felon from possessing a firearm. The right to be free from the threat of indefinite detention. No person shall be held for more than 24 hours without being publicly charged with a crime. The right to be secure in our persons to the extent not providing DNA or blood samples without court order. The right to be certain that we will not be tried by multiple jurisdictions for the same crime. The right to be held for a crime only if a victim to the crime may be readily identified and the government itself cannot be the victim. The right to be policed by law enforcement agencies and never by any agency or organization designed for use in war in a foreign country. The right to self-defense against government tyranny and unlawful acts by its agents. And there you go, folks. and it's rewritten. This is going to the president. And you can see, just fresh off the press, folks, 10 signatures. We need to get this viral. These are the rights that we have anyway. We shouldn't have to restate them. But because myself and many, many others really want peaceful solutions to these problems that have run amok and are blatantly visible. If you even took a day or two researching alternative media and comparing it to the mainstream media and really just allowed your mind to think things that you might not normally think. See, that's the point. You've been trained not to think like you might normally think. All the toxins in our environment, whether it be put there by evil people or if it's an accumulation of shit just because we're stupid humans. I'm not going to say during this video what my opinion on that is. I think it's a little both, actually. But we are. We're dummied down. We're tired. We're sheep-like. Even the ones that are awake, myself included, sometimes. You get in those ruts where you're sheep-like. Okay? We have to reiterate what our rights are. You know, you're not free unless you let yourself be free. Okay? And when you're under tyranny, the only way you're going to get free, the oppressor isn't going to let you go. Okay? So, anyway, before I get into a rant and distract from the message, please share this video. Obviously, all my videos are Creative Commons. You never have to ask. Thank you for the respect when you do. Please include the links because that's the point. We want people to get the information, not just hear Kevin speak. And anyway, the link to this will be below. And I'll also link you to the Million Mask March event page here on Facebook. And there you go. There's your update. 2,300 now confirmed just on Facebook alone. And this has gone global, folks. So you can hook up. Scroll through here. You know, say you're going and just try to do your best to get there. I know November's a long time away and some people don't like to make commitments. Listen, if you don't end up showing up, that sucks, but at least you had the intent, and at least in the meantime, you're talking about it and you think you're going, you're sharing the information with people, and more people will end up there just because you're going to try your best to go, okay? So anyway, there you go. Links will be below. Much love, many thanks, and I'll see you soon.